You might not think copper is worth more than a penny, but in today's global economy, it's actually worth a lot. For electric vehicles, windmill farms, even the power grid itself, copper is essential and in short supply.
At the start of the next decade, we're going to have a shortfall of over 5 million metric tons.
Here's why the metal has become so important and how a severe shortage is threatening the global push toward electrification.
Electrification essentially means moving away from relying so much on fossil fuels for our energy needs.
Copper is critical to electrification because it has the highest conductivity of any non-precious metal. That's important when trying to make an electric car or windmill efficient, so electricity isn't lost in transit.
So copper is actually used in a great quantity for these electric vehicles and other renewable energies, much more so than what you would use in a traditional fossil fuel power plant or traditional cars.
EVs require an estimated 4 times as much copper as gas-fueled cars. Wind and solar farms also typically need about twice as much copper as coal power plants.
Just to demonstrate how much copper is needed for electrification, by 2031, we're going to need over 35 million metric tons of copper. And supply, on the other hand, is supposed to lag behind at 30 million metric tons.
For decades, our nation has failed to meet the climate crisis with the urgency it demands.
Kamala Harris is talking about the Inflation Reduction Act, which has pumped federal funds toward green energy and electrification.
Through the law, you basically get tax credits and also other support if you are involved in the making of, you know, wind farms or factories that are making solar components and whatnot. And obviously, since copper is such a huge component of that, it's helping the prices for that as well.
In May, copper was trading at a little over $3.50, a dramatic increase from previous years. And those prices could continue to rise. Goldman Sachs estimates that demand for green uses of copper drives 7% of global consumption today, up from just 4% in 2020, and will account for a whopping 47% of total demand growth between 2023 and 2040. So it's no surprise that copper is the word on mining leaders' lips.
Copper, exciting copper development.
We're choosing to prioritize copper.
It sparked a flurry of consolidation in the industry. Glencore, BHP, Rio Tinto, and Newmont have all made moves to buy up other miners.
They've realized that copper is going to be in such a huge need over the next decade or so. So they have decided to instead go buy up other miners to get quick access to their deposits and get them producing in the market much faster.
But all of this consolidation can't create more copper. To find more, companies need to open new mines, which is very expensive.
What we're not going to do is simply go out and buy a stream of copper.
Analysts say that copper prices would need to rise to $15,000 per metric ton to attract investment in new mines. Today, prices are around $8,000 a ton. And starting a new mine can take a prohibitively long time. Deutsche Bank estimates that projects that start applying for permits today will take around 10 years to reach first production.
And that's just the permitting process. That's not even getting to the production part. So just imagine how long it would take for you to get any single mine in the producing stage.
Plus, new and current mines have also faced heightened scrutiny on environmental and social grounds.
There is increasing amounts of environmental unrest, social unrest with regards to them being online, especially as we've seen recently in some countries when they're trying to do that.
Mire, mire, señores.
In response to looming shortages, some companies are looking to change their products. For example, Tesla is changing the makeup of battery packs to cut copper usage in their EVs.
That means we need only about a quarter as much copper for in the car as would be needed for a 12-volt battery.
But these changes may not be enough. Electrification is only expected to increase, and with it, demand for this non-precious metal.
And that's going to be a thing that's going to define commodity markets for the rest of the decade. And a lot of people are also saying that this right now is the next big bull run in commodity markets.